I'm just looking out my window here, and this is an interesting little sky we've got here. Got a nice bit of blue on the left hand side and a predominantly white cloud, but you can see all the grey shadows within the cloud. So I think we'll have a go at this and then just put a simple landscape underneath. The first thing I'm going to do before I start this sky is make sure the paper's nice and wet. I'm just using the large paint brush and just saturating the paper basically, because I don't want it to start drying before I finish getting all the grey bits in. Now I'm just going to raw sienna, and the next I'm going to use ultramarine. There's quite a lot on this left hand side, so it comes around like so. Something like that. There's a little bit of, see a little bit through there. I'm going to do a quick sweep what will be the ground. In fact, I'll probably put a water scene at the bottom. So I just want to make sure there's some reflection of the sky now. While I've still got it on the brush, it's the easiest way of doing it. And the paper's still nice and wet, so I haven't got any problems with hard edges or anything like that. Now for the grey, I'm going into Payne's Grey and Alizarin Crimson. Nice strong mix. Not much water. Now you've got there's a darker bit up there. And that sort of comes down like that a bit. Some darker areas along the bottom. That's just a very simple way of doing the sky. I'm just going to pull this tight. For the land, I'm just going to use this photograph I've got here. I've used this one before in previous videos. It's Babb's Mill, like in Kingshurst. So, I mean, I've already got the reflection of the sky in, which I've put in. While I have the blue on the brush. So I'm just going to continue. To be honest, I've come down a bit too far with these clouds and I haven't left myself much landscape to work with. But never mind. I'll just keep the horizon pretty low, I think. So I'm just going into raw sienna and burnt and ultramarine. A very bluey green. I'm right down on the horizon line. Just trying to keep this level now parallel with the paper. Now as these on the left hand side get closer, obviously they're starting to get a bit bigger. So I'm just constantly varying the colour. I'm just going to pour that because you can see the water starting to creep up the paper. Not much detail in at distance, but as it gets closer I can start to put in a few branches and tree trunks. And now as we get even closer still, paint just gets stronger and stronger. And now we got some even thicker